It is always a pleasure to have Emma Stone with us here on GMA. She's co-starring with Michael Keaton in Birdman. The movie is generating a lot of Oscar buzz for both of them, and you're going to see why. A powerful scene we're about to show. The two of them, daughter, father, arguing about how desperate he wants to be relevant.
This is my chance to finally do some work that actually means something.
It means something to who? You had a career, Dad, before the third comic book movie. Before people started to forget who was inside that bird costume. You were doing a play based on a book that was written 60 years ago for 1,000 rich old white people whose only real concern is going to be where they go to have their cake and coffee when it's over. Nobody gives a shit but you.
Oh, ooh. Emma Stone is here, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my goodness. I mean, we always enjoy. You're always so kind and so thoughtful. Okay, that scene. Even when it ends like that, it stays on you. There's silence, but you could feel Michael Keaton. You could just feel the pain that he was in. It was just such a dramatic film.
Oh, it's really, what you're saying is part of the reason why I think the kind of genius of Alejandro Iñárritu, the director, and the DP, Emmanuel Lubezki, is so incredible, because there's no cutting away, there's no reaction shots. It's all one long, kind of beautiful, fluid take.
And we had Michael here yesterday, and Naomi was here earlier in the week, and they both talked about how it's a little complex and different, but it's interesting. You said you kind of like that. You kind of like that.
I did a lot because you, as difficult as it was, and as long as it took to kind of adjust to the choreography of it, because you were saying it felt like theater, it sort of did feel like theater over and over again, that needed to be perfect. But once we did so much rehearsal, and once you kind of got it in your bones, there was no ramping yourself up to do coverage or close-ups on other people. It was all just in the one shot. So it was kind of energizing, I guess.
Exhilarating. It comes, as somebody who's sitting there watching it, it's the same. There's just not many films like this anymore, Emma. That's a way to put it. Yeah. You referred to Alejandro. A lot of people are talking about him, and you said it's like a masterclass.
It is.
Being in his presence. What do you mean by that?
He's one of very few, I don't know if there are very few people left that are this way, or if he just is so insistently this way, but he doesn't compromise what he wants to make in any way that I saw, and he's so incredibly passionate, and he really doesn't let you rest on your laurels at all. So it's always pushing you to another level, and that, you know, is... That's what you hope for when you go to work. You want it to be a difficult and rewarding and not just
an easy day. That's why you do this.
Yeah.
St. James Theater.
Yes.
Holds a special place for you, The King and I, some classics that were there. And you as a young child, remember going there to that theater and being drawn?
I remember going to most Broadway theaters. We saw we got a lot of Rush tickets, and we saw a lot of plays when I was growing up. And so Broadway, there's a gnat in my face.
Sorry about that.
Gnat it up. Good stuff.
I know, but staying in character,
I think Broadway in general holds a lot, as it does for many people, a lot of really great memories.
Yeah, and you have Cabaret.
Yes.
Are you ready? Are you looking?
I don't know what ready means, but I'm working hard. I can't even describe how excited I am.
Oh, we're really excited to see you there on Broadway. And just, you know, the range, Emma. It's just, you are a true actor. And appreciate you sharing your talent.
This is
a good one. Thanks again for stopping by.
Thank
you. Birdman opens nationwide. Are you ready?
On Friday.
You're ready.